Good afternoon, everybody. Today we will be discussing the topic counting techniques. And we will discuss in this lesson methods of determining the number of possible outcomes when, number one, three coins are tossed. Number two, a pair of dice are thrown. Number three, seven cards are drawn from a deck of 52 cards. So you will notice that these are activities that you will see in a gambling casino, because this topic, counting techniques, is actually the first topic that is usually discussed when we are discussing the concept of probability. The concept of probability actually started years ago it was started by gamblers. Gamblers wanted to know the chance of winning a certain game, and so they asked some mathematicians to help them in finding out, determining systematically their chance of winning a certain game. So here you see these examples. Other examples wherein you will apply counting techniques are the following. Four class officers are selected from a class of 35 students. If you have a class of 35 students and you want to choose four class officers, how many possibilities could you have? Next, an outfit is chosen from six blouses, four skirts, and three pairs of shoes. How many possible outcomes can you have? Okay. Or in taking an exam, a 15-item exam with two choices for each number, that is a true or false exam. And also, if you have a multiple choice exam and you have four choices per item and there are five items in that exam, what are the possible or how many possible outcomes can you have, or how can a student determine if he has a chance of getting a passing grade? Alright, so we now discuss the different ways of determining those possible outcomes. We have here a tree diagram. A tree diagram is a systematic graphical device used to list all the possible outcomes of a particular activity. For example, when you toss a coin twice, these are the possible outcomes. In the first flip, you could have either a head or a tail. And in the second flip, you can again have either a head or a tail in this first outcome, and a head and a tail in this second outcome. And then we can now count how many outcomes there are in that activity. You will have more of that later. Here is another example using a tree diagram. When you are choosing a menu, for example, in a certain restaurant, and in that restaurant, there are two choices of a beverage, coffee or tea. And then there are three viands that you can choose from. Either a chicken, a beef, or a fish viand. A chicken, a beef, or a fish viand. And if you have to choose for your dessert, you have two choices, either a pie or a cake. So if we are to count all the possible outcomes in this activity, we can use the tree diagram to count that. And we will now do that activity with a specific example. We now have the tossing of three coins. Draw a tree diagram to show all the possible outcomes when a coin is flipped three times. And then we answer the following questions. Number one, how many outcomes are there in all? Number two, how many different ways are there to get exactly two tails? Number three, how many different ways are there to get at least one head? Number four, how many different ways are there to get three tails? And number five, how many different ways are there to get two tails and two heads? So now we will determine the answers to these questions using a tree diagram. Okay, so here is our tree diagram. So here we have three tosses. We are tossing the coin three times. Here is the first toss, here is the second toss, and this is the third toss. And then we put together all the possible outcomes. If in the first toss you had a head, and in the second toss you had another head, and in the third toss you had another head, so that outcome is described as an HHH outcome. Now, if you take this now from the head okay, you get a tail in the second toss and then another head, so we could call that an HTH outcome, and so on. So we can do that in all these events, and then we list them down. So we have an HHH, an HHT, an HTH, an HTT, a THH, a THT, a TTH, and a TTT. And from these three diagrams, we can therefore answer the questions that we had a while ago. The first question is, how many outcomes are there in all? So we count all of these. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 outcomes. So the answer is, there are 8 outcomes. Okay, let's go to the second question. The second question is, how many different ways are there to get exactly 2 tails? Again, we take the tree diagram. And from these choices, from these sample space outcomes, we now count, okay, how many outcomes have exactly 2 tails? When we say exactly 2 tails, that's different from at least 2 tails. When we say exactly 2, it means not less than 2, not more than 2. So exactly 2. So here, we see in this outcome that there are exactly 2 tails. This one is not exactly 2 tails. This one has exactly 2 tails, and so does this. This one has 3 tails, so it's not exactly 2 tails. It's more than 2. So the outcomes that have exactly 2 tails are 1, 2, and 3. So the answer to that question is 3 outcomes. Alright, let's go to the next question. The next question is, how many different ways are there to get at least 1 head? Again, we look at the tree diagram. So from these sample space outcomes, we choose those that have at least 1 head. When we say at least 1 head, it means 1 or 2 or 3 or more. Okay, so all of them that have at least 1 head are, okay, this one has at least 1, and so does this, and so is this, and so this one also. This one has 2, this one has 1, this one has 1. This one doesn't have a head at all, okay? So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them have at least 1 head. So answer is 7 outcomes. Now let's go to the next example. The next question is, okay, how many different ways are there to get 3 tails? So this is just like saying exactly 3 tails. And it is very obvious in this case that you have only 1 with exactly 3 tails. So the answer is 1 outcome. Now we take another example. The next question is, how many different ways are there to get 2 tails and 2 heads? Is there any among these space outcomes that would have 2 heads and 2 tails? Obviously, there's none. So, since here we have only 3 items here, we cannot have 4, wherein we have 2 tails and 2 heads. So, the answer here is 0.